Derek Spallone, glad to be alongside WNBA President Ms. Lisa Borders. Ms. Borders, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, we appreciate you taking the time out. And first and foremost, the Chicago Sky and Dallas Wings are moments away from tipping off. I know you mentioned you have to stay neutral, but what intrigues you the most about the Chicago Sky organization?
You know, they have a young team, but they have an incredibly talented team. They've got a great coach, and their ownership structure is a very, very good one. People that are completely engaged and committed to women's basketball. So they've got all the ingredients of a winner.
Yeah, and going along with that, your first year at the helm, but a part of the historic 20th season. I know you mentioned a few specific areas that you wanted to bring to the game, but what was your number one goal coming into this role for the league for now and moving forth?
So the number one goal is to run the league as a business, to look at what will drive top line revenue, because you want the league to be secure and sustained for generations to come. So we are looking at increasing ticket sales, making sure that there are people here to see these terrific athletes at every arena across the country, Chicago first among equals.
Yeah, absolutely. And something I'm sure helps out with that is the talent level that continues to flow into the WNBA. How exciting, but at the same time crucial is that, though, to have that continued flow, top tier talent coming into the league year after year after year?
Yeah. Well, like any business, if you don't have the best talent, your company doesn't perform.
Right.
The same thing is true in sports. If you don't have great talent, your team doesn't win. If your team doesn't win, what are we doing this for?
Right.
So the point here is that you've always got to have a pipeline of talent, and we see that coming from all the Division I schools. We have about 18% of our league is from international markets, so we've got talent coming from across the pond and across big waters. But we want to make sure that that talent is consistent and that there is a backload of talent that we can push through the funnel, draft those folks, bring them into the league, and make sure that the game stays fresh on a regular basis.
Perfect. And I know you mentioned you have a passion for the game of basketball, and you were very instrumental in bringing your hometown team to Atlanta. But how exciting, you know, was that having the team in Atlanta, your hometown, and then seeing the continued growth that the league has taken now?
Sure. Bringing that team to Atlanta almost 10 years ago taught me a lot about the sport and about the league. So it actually helped prepare me for the job that I have today. Incredibly exciting as vice mayor at that time to bring women's professional basketball to our city.
Yeah.
It's a terrific market. There are 18 colleges and universities in the metro area. It's a terrific media market, very much like Chicago. Mm-hmm. So when I look at Atlanta, I see comparable things in this city and a comparable team. So it was very exciting, amplified only by how much more excited I am to get to cheer for all 12 teams now.
Absolutely. And I mean, how does your passion continue to want to take this league to those new levels? I mean, just for your passion for the game of basketball in general.
Well, women are half of the country.
Right.
Women hold up at least half the sky, and that was not a pun unintended.
Yeah.
So I would tell you that I think women hold up even more than half the sky, and it's important to have women have the same access and opportunity as our male counterparts.
Yeah.
We are assets and resources in our community. We want to leverage our intellectual capacity, our memory, our muscles, our physique. We want to bring all of that to our communities. So this is an opportunity for young women who are exceptional at what they do to live out their dream, but they are iconic in many ways. They represent women all across the globe. So it's really important for us to support the Sky and all of our teams in the WNBA.
Perfect. And just my final question for you, aside from being fantastic basketball players, there are even better people in the community giving back. How special is that for you, seeing your players having the impact they have on the lives of the youth and the people, not only in the U.S., but across the world?
Well, there's a recognition that it's a twofer, right? You get an athlete and you get an amazing person, because they think beyond themselves. They want to bring everybody into the fold, support their individual efforts with their team, but support the broader community efforts by giving back on a regular basis. To whom much is given, much is required, and they never let us down.
Absolutely. And we look forward to many years of success under the helm, and we appreciate your time. Derek Spallone, Ms. Lisa Borders, thank you so much.
Pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you too. Thank you.
Thank you.